Okay, let me see if I can knock this out for you real quick. Hasnane, I'm not sure how to say your name exactly. But yeah, I appreciate you providing the contract addresses here. That helped a lot. So let's look at these in order. And I just went down your line here and went in order. First, I wanted to look at this. Hang on. So Nansen provided me with a way to look quickly into, you know, what Smart Money's doing in each of these. And not all of these are listed on here, but they are listed over here on the side. So we can see which ones have the most market cap right now as far as Smart Money entering them. So let's see. I want to make sure I've got everything like I want it first. So let's look at DEGEN first and just see if there's any Smart Money in it, because that would be the most important thing. Yeah, there's a lot of Smart Money in it. And it is trending up, so that's good. We want to see that for sure. We do have some of our favorite wallets in it. Wow, 700,000. I had no idea people were putting this much money into these. So it's a 1 billion fully diluted. I'm not sure what the market cap. Oh, I can actually look at it, can I? We're at 344 million market cap. Volume's coming down while price goes up. It's usually a bearish divergence. I mean, if I had to guess, I would say it's probably going to dip, but I don't know if it's ready to just yet. If it did, you know, you think in terms of things that are stepping up, you know, like they're stair stepping. So that's why I'm putting this line here. Let me just see what the fibs show on this. Because usually you want to see a 50% retracement. Wait, that didn't work. Why didn't that? Oh, it's not on log. That's why. Okay. Yeah, so our 50% line is right about there. So I would say I would shoot to add to this one at 0.055 roughly. And unfortunately, I can't put these on TradingView, I don't think, because TradingView doesn't do base yet. Otherwise, I'd be saving the chart. Let's look at, is Toshi on here? No. Okay, MF-er is on there. So we'll look and see. It's kind of flatline. I mean, it's going up a little bit on Smart Money accumulation, but one of our best wallets is in it for a ton of money. I'm surprised they put so much into these things. And then you could even see where they purchased it. Where's that? Oh, here it is right here. And he may have purchased it too high. I can't really tell because it doesn't go back far enough. But this could, yeah, I really liked the way this one looked today because it is stair-stepping up as well. So double bottom, stair-step, comes down, tags that, and it's ready to go. Or maybe it just goes sideways for a bit. But I kind of like the way this one looks. And the issue I have right now is I'm having trouble purchasing on base. I don't know why. You know, I bridged it correctly. Otherwise, I would have already purchased this one, but I haven't yet. Okay, let's see what's next. I said I was going to go in order here, but I think I'm already messing. Well, MFR, DGN, Toshi. Okay, let's look at Toshi. And I don't think I'm able to look at Toshi on here on the Smart Money. Hang on. Let's just double check here. Yeah, I don't see. For whatever reason, it's not showing up over here, but I can see it here. I can double-click this. So you can see accumulation has started to drop down, you know, overall. It's down to 508. It was, at one point it was at 1.5 million. Was that daily volume? I'm not really sure how to read this yet. Let's see, Toshi. Yeah, I mean, it just kept going up, but you know, volume is dropping off now. You know, you're getting this big move up like this, and then all of a sudden things start taking a hard move down. So momentum is definitely coming out of this thing. You know, it did a good job of doing its little stair step. So I would suspect that it's going to come back down to this support somewhere. And again, you can use your fib lines here to kind of get an idea. Well, it could stop right in here. I'd say around 0.0022, somewhere in there. It could even come down to just under that. So that's what I'd be looking for on that. What's next on the list? So we got Brett next. Yeah, Brett, we can look at smart money. I'm sure there's tons of smart money, not a whole lot. It's kind of climbing up as well. But the total balance, somebody's been selling off a little bit. We do have one of our people in it for 22K. So yeah, I mean, it's probably still fine on Brett. It's just, I think a lot of these are gonna need a breather. I mean, look at this massive move. I don't even know how to, I mean, could it come down to here? Maybe. I mean, at least it's gonna come down to 0.18 or so right in here. So you could start adding there, but if you get some kind of head and shoulders, it would probably come down to about the 0.5 or maybe right in here. So 0.05 would be a good place to buy. Volume's coming down as well on that one. What do we got next? Meow, or I don't even know how to say that, Maui. M-E-M-O-E-W. This looks like a, I mean, you could say it's a bull flag or a pennant. Yeah, it's a bull flag. I mean, this is lower risk, but I wonder, do we have that one on here? Surely it is. Nope, it's not. It's odd that it's not on there. Okay, well, that's fine. Yeah, I mean, from the chart perspective, I don't know. I mean, it's, at one time it was looking like a falling wedge, but now, I mean, it's kind of broken out of that. It just seems like there's not much interest in it right now. 4 million market cap, volume 274K. I mean, there's just not much money coming into it right now. And in general, I mean, compared to the other ones, there's not much interest in it. You know, I mean, look at the volume bars compared to something like Brett, you know. You know, these have a lot more interest in them. So I'd probably skip this one, but it, you know, it could get going at some point because of the cat meme thing. So you always want to buy things when they're boring, right? So you could add a little bit now. Here's another one. Doesn't have as much interest in it, doesn't seem like. Yeah, it looks like this could be the bottom right in here, 0.33. But I think there's a chance it could even dip a little bit further to 0.23, or, I mean, it could even come all the way down to 0.085 or so. It is bearish right now. That's a lower high. Volume's down. You know, interest in base while Bitcoin is down right now, it seems like, you know, everything is correcting some. So that was higher, and I can also look at smart money here. But it's clear, I mean, just based on the smart money, that people want to have a lot of conviction in these and throw a lot of money at them, hoping to make it big. This one's kind of flat. I mean, higher will probably go at some point, but I would at least wait till, you know, 0.09 or so, somewhere in here where this shoulder was before. And you got to be careful with these because sometimes you'll get a big pump out of them and they'll just like slowly work their way all the way back down. But there's just no way to know which ones are going to do that. Anime I kind of like right now because it's establishing a good base and it could just do a little tight consolidation for a while. It may not break out right away, but you know, you really want to see it break above this for sure. There's a line about right there. It's got to get above right around 0.03. If it can get above that, then that's the bullish line and you're in. Otherwise, your support is about 0.02. Hardly any volume though. And honestly, that's when you want to buy, when there's no volume. Okay, Boden, same thing. You know, this is actually a true falling wedge. So I kind of like this one really as far as that goes, but could it come down one more time? Yeah, it could. I'd wait for a full daily candle to pop out of here. Volume real low. Volume was massive at first though. Oh, that was because that green candle was there. Okay. So Boden is not over here either for smart money, but Toby is. Let's see. Volume is coming down on this one, but it seems to be kind of normalizing here. Yeah, it came down to the 0.5 here already, so this could be ready to go maybe, but it does have to get over this area. Yeah, that's the bullish line right there. It has to get above, and then this would be support. So that's 25.10. I mean, there's 7 zeros ahead of that, but anyway. Yeah, it doesn't look too bad. I mean, if it gets over this line, it's definitely got to take off. 16 million market cap, okay. MOG, I like the ETH MOG as well. I mean, it's got a really big community behind it. For whatever reason, this one just tanked at first. Yeah, it's a weird chart. I don't know really what to make of this other than to say it has to get above this line. Maybe even this line. Yeah. But you know what? It's interesting because that could be an inverted head and shoulders once it's all said and done, and then it just takes off out of there. I mean, I love the inverted head and shoulders, so I'd play it like this. I'd say 7312, which again, there's like 6 or 7 zeros before this, but I'd be watching for this breakout, and that's where I would enter if it had a daily candle above that. Yeah, I think that's it. Hopefully I covered all of them for you. I think I did. So just let me know if you got any other questions on that. It takes a little while for me to go over these things, but yeah, I try to do them from time to time if I have time to do it. I think that's all I wanted to say, yeah. So we'll end it there if I can find my little thing to stop the recording. There it is, okay.